Going to the supermarket in today's times and attempting to obtain the best quality food for your money can be like trying to interpret computer code as an English major. It's all Greek to the uneducated consumer. Organic, non-GMO, all natural, the list goes on and on. What exactly is the difference? Make sure you guys smash the like button as it really helps our small channel grow and get more exposure, and subscribe and hit the bell icon so you never miss a video. I think organic is a good place to start. It's become a buzzword but is essentially synonymous with just being healthier than non-organic. The first thing we must distinguish is that there's a difference from being 100% organic, and having certain organic ingredients. Being organic requires at least 95% of the food, by weight or fluid volume, to be produced organically. That's pretty encouraging already since the threshold is that high. However, if multiple ingredients are included, then only 70% of the ingredient must be organic in order to be classified as made with whatever organic ingredient. For example, say you're buying pasta with pesto. If the package says made with organic basil, that basil only needs to be 70% organically produced. This means that just because you see something that was made with certain organic ingredients doesn't make the product organic. This is where you need to use your judgment. If being organic matters to you, and I'll explain later why it should, then you need to realize the proportions. For example, let's take a look at these goldfish. The package says made with organic wheat, which is the most abundant ingredient. So that's good, but then you take a look at all the non-organic garbage they put into them, and it should make you reconsider your purchase. Most people would see this and just think, oh wow, organic goldfish, that's a better option. However, when you realize it's really just organic wheat, which is still problematic for most people, and a bunch of other non-organic toxic waste, it puts into perspective how much better it really is for you. If you're going to eat a food you know isn't healthy like goldfish, you may as well save yourself a couple bucks by not getting suckered into the organic ingredient trap. Okay, that's one important point, but what does organic really even mean? There's actually a ton of regulations that food producers must satisfy in order for a product to be considered organic. So I read through all of it because I have absolutely nothing better to do during lockdown. I mean, because I love you guys, and here's my synopsis. There are land requirements, meaning first off, the organically produced stuff has to be completely separated from non-organic. Essentially, the organic land requirements work to have the food be produced on as rich of soil as possible through natural management such as rotating crops. It also only allows for natural and not synthetic additives to the soil. However, there is also a list of synthetic substances that are allowed, like ethanol and ozone, and natural substances that are not allowed, like arsenic. Looking at the list, I think they did a good job of only allowing substances that are safe and necessary for use. The most important takeaway here is that no synthetic pesticides like glyphosate are allowed, which we know to be pretty toxic for humans. One thing that does stick out to me, however, is regulations for dairy cows. The USDA requires that they be treated in compliance with organic regulations for just 1 year prior to giving milk. Considering cows can only start producing milk after they give birth, which happens 3 or more years into their life, this is disconcerting. A cow could have been eating GMO grain sprayed with glyphosate for most of its life prior to becoming an organic cow. This cow will still have residues of glyphosate, a poor fatty acid composition, and other potential health problems that will be present in the milk. I don't think there's any reason for a fully sized human being to be drinking milk anyway, but if you want to, your best bet is just to do some more digging into the producers to see how they are raised in greater detail. If you're considering meat, know that the organic label does prohibit the use of hormones, but antibiotics and vaccines are still permitted if necessary for the animal's health. Just because the product doesn't explicitly say no hormones on the packaging doesn't mean they were used so long as the meat is organic. On the flip side, unless the package specifically states no antibiotics, they could have been used even if organic. Beware, the food industry is always trying to trick you. However, organic does not mean grass-fed. Cows are still permitted to eat grain for a significant portion of their life if organic. We did an entire video on grass-fed versus grain-fed beef, so check that out if you want to learn more about the differences. It is also possible that the meat is grass-fed but not organic. There are also labels that will say non-GMO, which is one of the characteristics of being organic, but one of many. Finally, there's the distinction between grass-fed beef and grass-finished or 100% grass-fed beef. Grass-fed beef only means that the animal was eating grass at some point in its life, while 100% grass-fed or grass-finished means that the animal consumed only grass throughout its life. This is a pretty big deal because most cows are given grass during the first part of their life, meaning there's nothing stopping some producers from just slapping grass-fed on their product to make it look better. Most people don't know about this, and it's a shame. For instance, take this beef right here. It says grass-fed on the front, but doesn't advertise that it's grass-finished. Take a look at the back, and in this text, which you would need a microscope to see, it indeed says that it is grass-finished. They don't have it on the front probably because most people don't know the difference anyway. What a shame. A pasture-raised label indicates that the animal is set free to roam and eat on fresh forage in a field for some of its life. Pasture-raised does mean grass-fed, but not grass-finished or organic, since it can still be finished eating grain. Grass-finished doesn't necessarily mean pasture-raised either, since the animal can still be in the feedlot eating grass that is given to them by the rancher. This is an important distinction because fresh grass will provide the animal with higher quality nutrition, which of course translates to your meat. The optimal beef would be one like this: organic, no antibiotics, no hormones ever, grass-finished, and pasture-raised. Perfect. By the way, I'm not getting commission from this company, but hey, if you work here, hit me up because I'd love to show this and get some free meat. Speaking of pasture-raised, let's talk eggs. There are so many damn types of eggs, it'll make your head spin, as if the organic, grass-fed discussion didn't already. Every time I send my dad to the supermarket, he comes back with the wrong eggs. He tries, but he never seems to succeed. Hopefully, he will watch this video. First off, we have normal eggs. No labels, just eggs. This is the environment you can expect conventional chickens to be raised in. Not a pretty sight, but hey, they're cheap and they can still give you some good nutrition for your buck. You will sometimes see a USDA grading on these kinds of eggs, AA, A, or B. What goes into these grades? They actually have an egg grading manual. Yes, an entire 56-page book on how to grade eggs. A book that you will be tested on if you plan on becoming an egg grader one day. Of course, since you can't crack an egg before you sell it, the grading system is done entirely on the shape, color, and texture of the eggs. The thought of some poor soul having a Quizlet with just different pictures of eggs is hilarious to me, but that's besides the point. Essentially, AA grade eggs are the freshest, then A grade, then B grade. Of course, if you're gonna buy conventional eggs, then try to go for the highest grade you can. We also have cage-free and free-range eggs. You might think that this means that the chickens were, you know, free, allowed to run around in the great outdoors all day like they're supposed to. Well, that's wishful thinking. These labels are a slight upgrade over conventional eggs, but these chickens aren't being treated like the kings and queens they are for giving us our recommended 45 eggs per day.
I said, no, I didn't say 45 eggs a day. I said 4 to 5 eggs a day, okay? And they go, oh, okay, yeah, you can come back.
Essentially, cage-free chickens are allowed to walk around the crowded barn instead of being caged up and have continuous access to food and water. It's like business class on United Airlines. Free-range chickens are a step up, with the same advantages of cage-free, but are also allowed continuous access to the outdoors during their laying cycle. Again, the absolute highest quality of eggs is pasture-raised, so the chickens can be outside having fun all the time. These are the kind of eggs I buy. Organic, free-range, and pasture-raised on over 8 acres. Yeah, these are only grade A, but give me a break, I'm doing the best I can. These are really the labels you should be focusing on.
There are a ton of other labels that mean little to nothing. For example, things like all natural and farm fresh. These types of labels have little to no regulations on them, except a statement to the USDA. For example, all natural only requires there be no artificial ingredients, which essentially means nothing when we're talking about eggs.
I could clone a chicken, have it lay a bunch of eggs, then slap all natural on the side of the carton and nobody can stop me. Crazy. Another label you might see is vegetarian fed, which sounds good, but again, doesn't mean jack. Chickens are naturally omnivores, eating grass, bugs, and essentially whatever else they can scavenge. So a vegetarian feed basically means they were chowing down corn and soy their whole life. If you see corn-free or soy-free, that probably just means they were eating whichever they didn't exclude. So again, not very important. Another common one is omega-3 eggs. The amount of omega-3 in an egg is going to be dependent on the quality of them to begin with. So what makes these special? These chickens will have flaxseed added to their feed, which is high in a precursor omega-3 fat called alpha-linolenic acid. The chickens eat the flaxseed, then convert them into the active form for humans, docosahexaenoic acid or DHA, which is one of the omega-3 fats in fish oil. If the egg is an omega-3 egg, just know that while you may benefit from some more omega-3 in your diet, it doesn't indicate anything else about how the chickens were raised. You will also see labels like humanely raised, which is another label that doesn't have defined regulations. If a producer wishes to include a statement like this on a product, they are required to provide reasoning to the USDA on why they believe that to be true. If the USDA approves of it, then it's good to go. Again, if you really want animals that were treated well, organic and pasture-raised are the best options. Finally, there are so-called special claims that need applications for the USDA as well. These include vague, ambiguous, and sometimes misleading claims like heart healthy and a good source of protein. Unfortunately, since it's clear that these regulating organizations don't know the first thing about nutrition and health, and they're just trying to take your hard-earned money, it's up to you to determine whether the product deserves to have that label on it. A good place to start would be by watching our videos, but be warned that you will quickly realize that almost all these claims are complete garbage. There are a lot of other label components I didn't discuss here, but can also cause confusion. If this video was helpful, let us know by commenting and liking so we can post a second part to cover more of them.